Welcome to the Security Zone at Google Next. We're here with Andy, a leading expert at Google in security operations and monitoring. Thanks for joining us, Andy.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
So we've all seen that security attacks are a big challenge for companies today. If I'm running a security operations and monitoring team, and I'm responsible for managing these threats, then this is going to be an increasingly difficult job for me, right?
That's exactly right. Security and operation monitoring teams always have new threats to worry about. So they have to constantly be improving how these threats are identified and how they're remediated. So let's take a look at a few of the common scenarios that a security operations and monitoring team needs to be able to understand and remediate.
Great.
The first scenario we're going to look at is these threats from your employees. So let's take a look at an example. Let's say one of your employees is about to leave the company and kickstart their new job. They've decided to share sensitive information from their corporate account to their personal account.
Oh dear, that is a problem.
Absolutely. This would result in potentially sensitive files being leaked to the public or to competitors.
So how can my team identify and remediate an attack like this?
Well, let's take a look at a view from our security operations and monitoring team. Here, we see the G Suite Security Center that has been seeing a huge spike in the external file sharing. So now your team knows that there is something suspicious going on, and they need to do some further investigation. There are hundreds of employees sharing files all over the company. One of the first things you need to do is identify which one is causing the huge spike in external sharing.
So we need to figure out who is sharing all this data.
Right. So if we go back to the G Suite Security Center and open up that report, here you can see that one employee, Julie, has by far the most sharing activity. The first thing we want to do then is to understand what she's sharing and if these shouldn't be shared outside the organization. And if so, then cut off Julie's access to these files from her personal account immediately. So again, back to the Security Center, we can go open Julie's file sharing details and see all the files she has enabled access to from her personal account. We can switch off all of her access to these files.
Wow, that was fast. So if Julie's trying to access or download these files right now, she won't be able to because her access has been revoked.
Exactly. The immediate threat now has been stopped, but we need to go one step further and prevent these leaks from happening again. We can choose to prevent individual users, groups of users, or the whole organization from sharing sensitive files externally like this again.
Got it. So there may be a subset of users at the company that we want to stop from leaking files like this.
Yes, that's right. If we took a look again at the G Suite Security Center and the Security Health screen, we can see that there's a recommendation to remove drive external sharing access to employees. I can easily go in and turn that off. And now we've remediated the situation for the whole organization.
Wow, so we were able to quickly identify the threat, remediate it, and then we adapted security controls to prevent it from ever happening again.
Right. So as a security and operations team, tools like G Suite Security Center can give you the ability to quickly identify, remediate, and prevent these types of employee insider attacks. So that's how your team can protect against employee insider attacks. But another potential threat you may need to be concerned about is possible data access from your cloud provider's employees. And to address that concern, Google has introduced Access Transparency, which is unique to Google Cloud Platform and provides an audit trail of actions taken by Google support and engineering when they interact with your data and the system configurations on Google Cloud. So let's walk through a scenario that shows off Access Transparency. So say that one of your employees is having problems accessing some of the files that needs to call Google support. Once that employee is speaking to a Google support agent, the employee walks through the problem, and to fix the problem, the Google support agent needs to access some of the customer system settings.
So at this point, an employee at our cloud provider, Google, needs access to some of the system data to diagnose the problem.
Right. So as a security operations and monitoring team, you want to be aware of how the cloud provider's employees access your systems. So let's take a look at Google support agent's view. To diagnose the problem, the support agent needs to access a particular system, but before they can get that access, they must enter a justification for the additional access. Before they can access any of the system's data, they need to log this request detailing why they need the access. So now the Google support agent is able to access a limited set of your system settings in order to diagnose the employee's problem. The support agent is then able to help your employee solve the problem. So on the Google Cloud Platform, let's take a look at the Security Command Center. We can see that the support agent's access request has been logged after they've entered it. If we open up that record, your team now has transparency into how the cloud provider's employees, like the support agent, are accessing your systems. Here we can see accesses to the systems, when, what they accessed, and the support agent's justification for the access requests. So now your team can monitor this access, help ensure that your cloud provider's employees are interacting with your data and systems appropriately. So that's two examples of insider threats. First from your own employees, and second from the cloud provider's employees. Another common scenario your team has to worry about is external threats. Let's say you have systems with varying levels of data sensitivity. In Google Cloud Platform, we enable you to programmatically classify the data in your system using our DLP API. By understanding the level of the sensitive data within each project, we're able to proactively assess our attack surface and potential blast radius. Now let's say an attacker was able to attack your systems and compromise one of your machines.
So this is an external attacker who has made a targeted attack against one of our systems.
Right. So now that this machine has been compromised, your team needs to identify this problem and, based on the blast radius of the attack, understand the impact of the incident. In the Cloud Security Command Center, you can see how we surface anomalies that have been detected and identify the compromised machine. Using machine learning, Google Cloud is able to identify unique patterns across systems and can trigger detections for your team in the Cloud Security Command Center. And you can drill down here and see the details of the compromised machine. Now the attacker's access to the compromised system can be shut off, and the blast radius impact can be determined by calculating the sensitive data compromise across the affected machines. With the Google Cloud Security Command Center, your team can quickly identify and remediate these external attacks on your systems and calculate the impact of the attack. So that's how your team can protect against insider threats and external threats. But another challenge that security teams have to worry about is how they can integrate different security tools across the company. Most security teams are using a lot of different tools for things like advanced threat and endpoint security, advanced network security, DDoS and firewall protection, and configuration security and compliance.
So if our team is managing a whole group of security tools, we need to make sure that they're all talking to each other.
Right. Otherwise, your team might miss some security threats because security threats are being managed in too many systems and places that don't communicate with each other. Google Cloud partners with many of the top security companies in the world to make it easy to integrate their solutions in the Cloud Security Command Center. For example, one partner that Google Cloud partners with for advanced threat protection and endpoint security is CrowdStrike. CrowdStrike provides advanced malware detection and advanced endpoint protection capabilities to help your team identify threats fast. In the Cloud Security Command Center, CrowdStrike data can be exposed as a new card so your security team can easily see these threats and actions on them from one place.
So if there's an error detected in CrowdStrike, our team can see it in the Cloud Security Command Center?
Right, and clicking into the card takes you straight into the Cloud Security Command Center's findings inventory page, pre-filtered for just the CrowdStrike results. This is where we surface key properties of the findings that were provided by CrowdStrike. Your team can then explore the finding by clicking into its detail page, and if your team wants to investigate in more depth, they can click on the link back to the CrowdStrike console. Google partners closely with top security partners to make integration between these tools and the Cloud Security Command Center easy, and enables your team to unify, index, and search across all your finding sources. Here, we can add new cards to connect with partners like Palo Alto Networks, like CrowdStrike, like Cloudflare, like RedLock, to help you have a holistic view of your attack surface and your security.
So now my team can identify and action threats from all these applications using just Cloud Security Command Center.
Right. So your team can now get the most out of all your security tools, manage them all in one place. Google Cloud has a growing ecosystem of security partners that we are working closely with to make sure that our customers have access to the best tools and quickly identify and remediate actions.
So with Google Cloud, I can manage insider threats, cloud provider threats, external threats, and I can integrate it into the rest of my security tools, right?
Right. With Google Cloud and the Security Command Center, your team can manage these threats and work to constantly improve security controls as these attacks get more sophisticated.
Andy, Thanks so much for walking me through how to manage a modern security operations and monitoring team.
Happy to do it, and thanks for your time.